Catherine Tyson was born and raised in Georgetown. Growing up on Walker's Road, she developed a love for people where she inspired many from a tender age. Catherine's roots are on Walker's Road, where she was raised by her great-grandmother, Valerie, her mother, Ida, and her father, Truman. Many still remember her as Little Rosita, or Rosa, as some still call her. Catherine regularly went with her great-grandmother to the Georgetown Seventh-day Adventist Church, and some may still remember her standing on chairs in the church singing or leading song service. Her love for people and ability as a leader was clear to everyone from that very young age. As a young child, she attended Edmer, SDA, and Truth for Youth School, which set the foundation for her dedication to education and discipline. Catherine spent many years in the United States, however, graduated from the Cayman Islands High School in 1984 and also Triple C School in 1986. That same year, she joined the police service, where she began to serve her community and fellow Caymanians. After a short time in the service, she left to further her education abroad. She attended Miami-Dade College, Florida Atlantic University, and Barry University, where she attained degrees in psychology and social work. After receiving a master's degree in social work, Catherine returned home in 1998 and joined the Cayman Islands government as a social worker.
Catherine Tyson from the Department of Social Services. Welcome to Daybreak, Catherine.
Thank you.
Now, you actually helped organize this event for 3 years, but you weren't here last year.
Right.
Last year you were missing for a year. You were missing in action.
Missing in action. Yeah, I actually went away last year to study.
And now you're back in.
Now I'm back in, yeah. And I have a master's degree now.
Well, congratulations.
Thank you.
Among other things, she helped individuals and families and vulnerable people at a community level to access government resources while always advocating for their needs. During that time, she assisted many single mothers who were struggling to cope with all the consuming task of raising their children. These struggles resonated with her, as she too faced some similar problems in the past while raising her 3 children. She passed on to these mothers various ideas and methods that she had developed over the years for making ends meet, thereby empowering them to help themselves rather than to wait for someone to help them. Catherine has always had a love for the people around her, as she demonstrates this by helping and investing her time and skills for the benefit of the community. Throughout her 16 years as a civil servant, she started off as a social worker, where she worked on the Christmas for Kids program, where private citizens and businesses donated money, gifts, and food for children less fortunate to ensure that they had a good Christmas. She also developed a summer food drive to assist families with food during the summer holidays.
The focus of it is to provide Christmas and Christmas gifts, Christmas food baskets for families that may otherwise not have Christmas that we know. We have a lot of families in need in our community. Usually we target probably close to 200, maybe more families. So it's a lot of children that we target during that time of year as well. At Christmas time, the families are bombarded, and not to sound like we're not interested this time of year, because it's wonderful. And the origin of it, like I said earlier, is because the families were not able to enjoy, you know, the festivities, or because of the lack of funds or resources or whatever. So originally that was the plan. But now what we notice is every organization just gets on the bandwagon at Christmas time. So at Christmas time we have so many things for the children, gifts, toys, money, activities, parties, everything. And then when Christmas Day goes by, there's nothing. So if organizations could kind of put in their calendar, you know, 12 months, and they can say, well, in April we'll do this, or in July we'll do this, that would be really helpful too, because that means it's continued giving spirit throughout the year.
Catherine has also been involved in running summer camps from a grassroots level to a management level since 1999, providing affordable quality summer and holiday camp assistance to parents, where she incorporates reading, writing, and social exposure. In 2004, she became the National Housing and Community Development Manager, which provided housings for hundreds of families displaced by Hurricane Ivan, and also programs for children to keep them productive and positive. 2 consecutive years, she arranged trips abroad to take the children who lived in the trailers for a break from their environment. They traveled to New York the first year and Disney World in Florida the following. This trip was funded by donations and fundraising by Catherine and her team of parents and workers and the children themselves.
A group of Cayman children took a big bite out of the Big Apple recently.
I mostly like the big buildings because you don't see a lot of this in Cayman.
This was no ordinary trip. For most of these kids, it was their first time off the island. They left behind the trailer homes they live in, if only for 4 days.
It was nice, and for me, it was like someone actually cared about us. Like, sometimes people don't come in to check how you doing, like, check if you're right, if you're alive or dead. But this, we can see that people actually care about us. We're not nobodies.
Because they live in the trailers doesn't mean that they shouldn't get a chance to go away, to see something, to go to a musical, to be in New York for 5 days. I mean, just that alone is a break from their situation. So yeah, they go back to the trailers. But they go back to the trailers with something different in their brain, in their mind, that they didn't have before. And that is an opportunity for other things other than what I see every day when I step out of my trailer. So to walk the streets of Manhattan and have the opportunity to be in a different world, to see museums, to see a play, to eat different food, to see thousands of people on the street, Cayman is just one little dot in the reality of our lives. There is so much more out there.
They're excited. My children is excited. Yeah, because they want to come back and they want to see different things and they want to shop. So they're really excited.
Government did not fund any of this. Basically, this was done from people's generosity. We were doing fundraising events. We solicited donations. The children walked around with donation papers. People donated $1 to $50 to $100. Civil servants were asked to give $5 apiece. We got a couple of nice donations from civil servants. We got a really big one from Maples and Calder. Foster's Food Fair Woody, who's always very good about helping out in these types of things. UBS, so we got a couple of big donations, but mostly these children and I and the rest of the staff walked around with papers soliciting donations. That's how this trip was paid for.
I would love to see New York again, come to the same Marriott Hotel.
I would miss Cayman because I was born in Cayman and all of Cayman's beauty just means so much to everyone in Cayman Island.
She creates and delivers programs for the unemployed as well as the socially and behaviorally challenged students to help them with professional grooming and social polishing to prepare them for the workforce.
I think when I came back from school last year and went back to the department in September, we were just inundated on this intake team, which has been going on for years anyway, period. But since I came back in September, we were inundated with all of these concerns and clients that were presenting with the same problems, the same stories. When we go read back into the notes, because we have a note system, a recording system, but we can go back a few years and we're able to look at the client's history. And what we had seen was it was the same situation. In 94, for instance, we were assisting with rental. 95, we assisted with rental. 96, and so on, so on. The same types of problems. What we did as an intake team, we just became really frustrated, and we'd go into our supervisor's office and say, listen, this person, why is this person still presenting for this? Why hasn't something else been done? Sat down and said, let's come up with something, let's do something. And we identified particular clients that seemed more inclined to just change their lifestyle, but for the opportunity, but for the resources. So we sat down and this is what we came up with, STARS. And STARS is abbreviations for Support Towards Autonomy, Retraining, and Self-Sufficiency. STARS has to do with retraining people. So it's about vocational, it's about academic, it's about educational, and it's about maintaining their self-sufficiency. But we would support them, carry them, during this time as we assist them with the rental, with the food, because they still have their basic needs that need to be met. Our supervisor went back into a system where you can go back and see how much money we've spent on clients, and he came up with something like $300,000+ we had spent on food in like 3 months. It's just money that we're continuing to spend, and these people will continue to present with needs. However, if they're interested in a course, if we're supporting them through something at the end of that year or whatever, however long that is, that they can
get a job and maintain that employment, then that's done. This person can maintain themselves. And that's really what most of them want, these STARS people that we've seen. That's mainly what they want. So, but also in STARS, we have a dressed for success part of it. We have a part where, we're teaching them about interviewing, not only just getting a job, but how to interview for a job. There's so many different aspects of it that we're looking at. I mean, looking at transportation, childcare, all of the barriers that kind of stop people from improving. And I think, just saying single parents, it's really tough. I'm a single parent, and for the difference sometimes that I see between me and my client may be the lack of opportunity, the lack of support, the lack of understanding, the lack of education. There's so many different things that stops them from doing what I've done. So I've not done anything wonderful and great that's different than anyone else could do if they have the opportunity.
She has done professor work at the local colleges and facilities, self-development and work skill courses for the Chamber of Commerce and the corporate world. Catherine has organized women's retreats and women's conferences since 1999 for small and large groups, helping women to share their experiences and pass on wisdom as they are inspired and empowered. Catherine has written motivational columns for the newspaper for many years and currently writes for the Caymanian Reporter and the Caymanian Times. Her voice is familiar as it can be heard on Radio Cayman's Talk Today and most recently for The Record, where she is a host since 2009. She is the producer and host of a television show, Lighten Up with Catherine Tyson, where her moniker is to simply lighten up and get out of your own way. The show has been aired regionally throughout the Caribbean since 2011. Catherine is the author of the book I'm Somebody's Mama, a book about her life as a single mother to three children, David, Richard, and Caitlin. She began her journey when they were 6 months and 4 and 5 years old. Today they are now adults and all university graduates. I'm Somebody's Mama has taken her many places around the world as she became a spokesperson for the single mother plight. She is a dedicated family person and values her time with the people that love her. Her decision to serve her country in this capacity is the next natural step.
My mother had three of us by the time she was 19, for three different people. You imagine them days in 1960-something when people were looking down at her?
1969. Imagine, 1969, a 19-year-old had three children. That's a tough story. That's a tough story for what we went through. By the help of my grandmother, my great-grandmother actually, because what people don't know about that story is that teenage mother had lost her own mother by the time she was about 8 or 9. So when the community could look at her and say, wow, she had a baby at 16, or she had a baby at 17, or she had three by the time she was 19, they didn't understand her story was a lot bigger than that. And so she lost her own mother at 8 or 9 years old. She was in Honduras. Her grandmother then had to go get her dead daughter's children and bring them over to the Cayman Islands. People don't know that part of the story.
I went through a lot of stuff in my life, trust me. I moved about 12 times in my life. I moved about 8 different schools, US and in Cayman. Every time I turned around, I was moved somewhere. So I'm not telling you that what you see, you should believe, because you don't know what you see sometimes. Sometimes you see something and you don't know the biggest story, right? The community helped raise me. My grandmother helped raise me. At 26 years of age, I got married at 20, and by 26, I was a single mother to three little children. When me and my husband broke up, I was 26 and my children were 6 months, 4 and 5. Imagine, and I was in the US. I had three little children. So I was a poor thing. But let me tell you what I did as a poor thing. I knew I had to educate myself. When I graduated high school in Cayman, I only had two passes, drama and English, and you can't get into college with that. But today I stand before you and can tell you I have a master's degree because that is something that I did for myself. But it was with the help of people who recognized certain things in me. So I told you that story to let you know what you see is not sometimes what it is. There's always a backstory. Because I have the backstory that I have is the reason why I know I can come to your door and say, what do you want to do with your life? And I can help you get there. Because you can get there no matter what.